Welcome everybody to Forza Horizon 4, and today we're taking a look at a new Horizon story. And yeah, as you can see by the map, it's a Top Gear Horizon story. You might be wondering why I'm in a Ferrari 488. Well, basically this car had a more powerful version on the first episode of the new Top Gear series, so I thought it would be appropriate to come in a car that was featured on there, even though it was the more powerful and more track version of it, called the Piste. So or Pista, or whatever it's called. So yeah, we're going to take a look at this Top Gear Horizon special. So let's take a look. It is only a 7 chapters, so we'll probably only do it in one episode. Usually these Horizon stories are 10 chapters, so 7 we should be able to do in one episode. So yeah, there should be 3 new vehicles to try out as well. I have seen the trailer that is on the Forza YouTube channel, so hopefully we'll get to drive them and unlock them. But yeah, no idea what the challenges are going to be or anything like that. So I don't know why the season is changing, and we ain't, or is it? Well, here we go.
Tonight, the Stig drives some very fast farm equipment, I hail a taxi, and finishing with something that I'm reliably informed is a bit of a fan favourite around here. I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special.
It's pretty cool that they got Chris Harris to do it.
The Stig, our very own UFO, unidentified fast object.
The Stig,
least obedient racing driver.
That's cool.
Right then, the Lotus Elise, a 90s classic based on the age-old Roadster recipe. 2 seats, engine in the middle, rear-wheel drive. Not an ounce of fat. This is what driving is all about. You've got it. The trick with drifting is to not actually spin, but to almost spin for as long as possible.
Didn't realize we had to stay above 90.
But this isn't just any Elise. It's a Sport 190, a tuned-up, stripped-out Elise for track days. Even the passenger seat is an optional extra. But who needs friends anyway? Friends are expensive and heavy.
Yeah, he's certainly better at reviewing this car than I was. Which I reviewed
it weighs well
a while back.
700 kilos and makes 190 horsepower from its 1.8-litre engine, which drifts to 8,000 RPM. Just listen to that.
Yeah, this is a great car. Not practical at all, but a great car. I don't think we're going to get 3 stars on this one. Too busy enjoying the moment.
Of course, because it's a Lotus, it sticks to the famous philosophy of the man who founded the company, Colin Chapman. Simplify, then add lightness, he said. The Sport 190 also adds a 4 roll cage, just in case.
Yeah, because there is no roof, so if you did roll over, good luck without a roll cage. Probably was a shortcut to get to this destination, the 3 star allotted time, but I'm just enjoying driving this car and this Horizon story. Really too fussed about getting 3 stars and everything straight away.
Made it! Was there ever any doubt? The Series 1 Elise is, after all, one of the best handling cars ever made. The Sport 190 is its hardcore cousin, a road-going racer you can drive to work. And across fields, it turns out. But if it's true agricultural transport you're after, we have just the thing.
I know what he's talking about, because if you've seen the trailer, you will also know what he's talking about. But if you don't, I'll save it until we get there. Yeah, I'm enjoying this. I really didn't expect him to have Chris Harris talking in the story. I thought it was just going to be a few chapters and get a few vehicles out of it and didn't expect him to be a part of it, so that's pretty nice. It's cool that they are doing these updates, because yeah, just gives more content, and if you really haven't bought this game yet, then you're in for a treat with the amount of content that there is on offer, DLC wise or just free updates. But you will have missed out on all those seasons, so yeah, some exclusive cars will have gone by here.
Ooh, a BMW 1M. Great car. Hang on, that's my BMW 1M.
I'll try not to trash it.
Seriously, not funny. Who gave Stick the keys?
He's got good taste in cars, because this is one of my favourite modern BMWs.
I literally just cleaned it! I was going to smell of onions. Odor stick. Does 0 to 60 in 4.8 seconds, my 1M. Stig's way beyond that now. Look at the smoke! Please leave me some tread for the drive home, Stiggy. Seriously, come on!
Is this the version that's in the game, or is it a new one? Because I can't remember it driving it all that much on here.
Am I the only one who remembers Budapest? Well, this isn't stressful to watch. Not at all. It's a BMW, so of course it's rear-wheel drive. 50-50 weight distribution, too. It's a natural-born drifter.
Which is bad when it's not your... when it's your tyres and someone else is driving it.
Three-litre straight six, 335 horsepower, two turbos, as much sideways action as you like.
In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Another good thing with these Horizon stories is you drive cars that you possibly never driven all that much before.
155 miles an hour, but it could definitely go quicker.
Yeah, no electronic restrictions on the cars on this game.
One of the best BMWs ever made, this. Born to be driven by me. Got to admit though, Stig does kind of suit it.
At the roundabout, take the second exit. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Oh dear. I nearly went wrong.
Almost there now. Oh, what a shame. I was really getting into that. Just park it up now, Stig, and line the curbs. Now, anyone else want to go? No? Don't say I didn't ask.
Yeah, I think Stig's got well and truly all of it out of it.
Right. Back to the actual script now, if you don't mind. This is Top Gear's Track Tour. It's a tractor, obviously, but with a 5.7-litre Chevy V8 making 500 horsepower. And here comes the Stig again. Farm Stig. Born in a barn, they say. Weaned by pigs. Can plow a field in under 6 seconds.
Employ Stig then if you want to get ploughing done right.
There's a speed camera on the M68. Rumour has it, it only flashes above 87.2 miles an hour. Our tractor has been officially clocked at 87.2 miles an hour, making it the world's fastest tractor. But I reckon it'll go even faster.
Well, we're certainly going faster than that now. I love it when they put weird, quirky vehicles like this in a Forza game. I know some people will be like, where's the hypercars, where's the supercars, where's the 200 mile an hour, 2 million pound cars or whatever, but yeah, I do like these more quirky vehicles. Should hopefully mean we get some weird and quirky videos out of it as well. Look forward to seeing what this can do on an extreme off-road silly build video or...
Those are 54 inch mud tyres, remember? They get a bit squishy through the corners. Nobody needs to get the harvest in that quickly.
Oh dear. See the BMW turning there. Yeah, interesting to see what you can do upgrade-wise to this.
Here comes the speed camera. Hope they put some film in it. Whoa! Have you ever seen anything like it? That's a new tractor speed record and some impressively fast farming. If you want to spread slurry in a hurry, you know what you need. Now, though, it's time to hail a ride in something completely different.
Slurry in a hurry. I like that. Oh, dear. That's funny. But, yeah. Pretty sure we'll get to unlock that at some point. We'll get a Stig t-shirt at some point. But yeah, this Forza game's really surprised me with the updates, with the level of detail that they've gone to, be it with the expansions or the season playlists, with the kind of cars that I wouldn't expect to see on a Forza game. And then they're going to do a Top Gear Horizon special story like this with Chris Harris actually taking part. It's just, they've really gone above and beyond with this game and the updates.
I called a back in this local company, Aisha's Taxis. Excellent service, got me here in no time. Unsurprising, really. I mean, look at what turned up. Hands down the quickest cab I've ever been in, which got me thinking, how fast could this thing actually go?
Well, we've already seen what this car can do, but it is nice to be back in it.
So I had a word with Aisha, asked if we could borrow her cab for a trip to the seaside. To Bamborough Beach, in fact, where we could stretch the taxi's legs a bit. Although, I might have forgotten to tell her who'd be driving. You've guessed it, the cabbie who'll always get you to your destination very early, but probably won't be anywhere near where you asked to go. Oh, I see. The Stig's warming up the tyres. A good old-fashioned rolling burnout. We ordered some spare rubber, right?
I nearly spun out at the same time.
Holding a grip is a delicate balance of throttle, steering and shouting.
And grip as well at some point, and not water on the ground either.
Now that's what I call a cab. No clattery diesel engine here. This has a V12 with over 750 horsepower. Plus bucket seats. Beaded bucket seats, presumably.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with this car's original engine. It's perfect in every way.
From now on, I say all cabs should have wide bodies and flared arches. Think about it. More stability, more speed, more downforce. More room for your terrified passengers.
Let's come as a crow flies, see what this thing can really do.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
It even has slick tyres for maximum grip on a bone-dry drag strip. So they should be interesting when we hit the beach.
Yeah, it's certainly interesting just going off road. No grip whatsoever. I wonder we're slightly struggling in the rain as well. No. Does not like dealing with traffic.
In 400 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Anna, this is not an appropriate road for a car like this.
Yards.
get stuck in the sand.
Good work from the stick there. I'd say we're nicely warmed up for the next bit. So here we are then. In the old days, daredevils used smooth, sandy beaches like this to see how fast their cars could go. Many early land speed records were set on beaches. Miles of space, nothing to hit. Sounds easy, right?
No. Lack of grip. Gonna end up in the sea.
Laying some pretty squirmy tracks there, Stiggy. That's what happens with 750 horsepower on sand. But that's the challenge here. Go as fast as possible all the way to the top of the beach. The thing is, there's something I haven't told the Stig.
What? What haven't you told the Stig?
Record rules say you must do two runs, one in each direction, before the clock runs out. Which means, Stiggy, pulling off the world's swiftest U-turn.
Alright then. I'll do a swift U-turn then.
Which of course is when the handbrake comes in handy.
Yeah, and not flying off into the weeds, come on. Oh my god. Some warning would have been nice, Chris. God. Gonna have to brake a lot earlier, because, yeah, this car has no grip on this kind of surface. And some off-road tyres when you need them. I need to be going faster than this. Ten seconds or so. It's getting rather bumpy, but we've done it. Yeah.
Ride from the Stig there. Mini cab, maximum speed. Next time I need a ride to the airport, I know who I'm calling. And all of this off-road action has given me an idea.
Yeah, because the thing you need is more crazy ideas. But yeah, nice to come back to that taxi after using it so much in Aisha's taxi's business story or whatever. It's a while ago though now that. Oh look, another car that we're going to be probably driving at some point. And the kind of car I've been wanting more of in games like this, to be honest, along with some other stuff, but more often nonetheless. Right, yeah, we're gonna do all of these, and we've got plenty of time. There's no point splitting it up into two smaller videos when we can just do one sizable one. Yay!
This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many bears around here, though. Mostly badgers. Still, there's definitely some terrain. Lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction. Or not. Here's Stig again, looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently. Inner compass points directly south.
So yeah, not the exact kind of car that I'd want, but it's an estate, and I've always wanted estates.
55 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary, and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres, and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
One extra knobbly tyre.
Turn left.
Yeah, I want more estates in Forza games, to be honest.
Turn left.
Especially the more sporty kind. But despite the fact this only has a V6 diesel, it's hardly slow. I have to admit, I would like it as a standard version in this game, though. But you know, maybe we are able to strip off the unnecessary guff that's on it for this Horizon story. Ooh, nice interior. Nice crisp clean dials.
Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The E80 has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example.
It is a slightly higher off the ground.
Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back.
400 yards, turn sharp left.
That's some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
Turn sharp left. Recalculating route.
No need, Anna. I can see perfectly well where I'm going.
Turn sharp left.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds.
It's a fairly decent amount of horsepower, to be honest. Whether or not that's a standard amount that one of these gives out, whether it's V6 diesel, I don't know, but it's still fairly good. Obviously, a lot of people now are a bit more wary about diesel after all of the emissions scandals that were going on with Volkswagen and the like. You have their place, especially when it comes to off-roading and pulling heavy loads.
Now it's time to head way over there, to the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down.
Geronimo! Yeah, it can handle it. If it can deal with me, it can deal with anything.
That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres, completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon.
Damn it. Did not see the big wooded tree.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Why, Anna? I know what I'm doing.
Yards. Turn left.
Ford every stream and all that.
It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting. Even a portable espresso machine. Everything the intrepid explorer could ever need.
I wonder whether or not this is going to be a part of one of the future episodes of Top Gear. I can't remember the track tour being in the previous episode.
Take the first exit.
Oh, I've just forgotten.
In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right.
That's the problem with diesels, though. They run out of puff quite quickly.
A tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds two cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water.
Don't think we're going to get 3 stars, though. Pretend to spend a bit too much time off-roading. Nope. Oh no, we've got 10 seconds more, given that's not enough.
Take the first exit.
On to the final stretch now. Just the small matter of getting up Arthur's Seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
Oh well, we'll get 2 stars. At least I know what to do in the, when I try and get it the next time round.
Thank you.
top of Arthur's seat. No idea who Arthur is, by the way, or why his seat's so big. Nice view, though. Shame there's no time to stick around.
Indeed there isn't. Yeah, we'll unlock that now that we've done that, so I look forward to checking more of that out in a future video, if I feel it requires one. There we go. And then the tractor will be the next unlock. Which again, I am looking forward to seeing what it's more capable of. Especially since 500 horsepower doesn't seem all that much for such a large V8 that it has. Right. Next. Come on. Yay, Mini.
Now I said we'd be driving some British classics, and you don't get more British than a car built in Birmingham designed by a man from Greece. Anyway, here it is, an original Mini Cooper S, an icon of 60s engineering. It was designed for cities, but this is the wide-body one, so we're going to need a bit more room. And I know just the place. Ready, Stig?
Yeah.
The Mini is cleverly packaged, capable of carrying four people and their luggage. Hand luggage, presumably.
Quicker than the Lego Mini that we've had for so long on the Lego expansion series.
The Cooper S was the car to beat on the famous Monte Carlo rally. It pretty much wiped the floor with the competition.
You can see why, because the Monte Carlo rally is quite tight and quite narrow. And it's mostly tarmac orientated, so yeah. A city car like this is more than able to deal with that kind of thing.
The Cooper S was developed by a bloke called John Cooper, who also built F1 cars, so it had real racing pedigree.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
And it wasn't just Monte Carlo either. The British Saloon Car Championship, the Thousand Lakes Rally, even the Australian Touring Car Championship. Almost any time the Mini turned up, it won.
In 100 yards, turn left. In 200 yards, turn right. Turn right.
Oopsie. Going to be a drag race or something.
And here we are. Told you it was spacious. We've got everything we need here. An airfield, the original rapid runabout, and the stick. I'm looking forward to this.
So am I. What are we doing?
Look at that, laying down some rubber.
Skill
there.
Stock it. Not easy peasy.
After all, tiny wheels mean tiny tires. Now that's just showing off. What is it with minis and shipping containers? They sold nearly 5.5 million minis. But only this one could fly, apparently. Short wheelbase, front wheel drive. It's really not an easy car to slide, this. This little Mini punches well above its weight. It's literally unstoppable. Forget rallying, this thing was made for demolition derbies.
Getting in the way of that.
Yes, all about. No wonder it was pretty much unbeatable. Maybe that's why its basic design lasted for over 40 years.
And they need to keep these skill chains going a lot longer than about 9,000.
See, the Mini wasn't just designed for nipping around town. It was also a proper racer and won the British Saloon Car Championship a whopping 5 times. Good work. It might be Mini on the outside, but it's Maxi on the inside. Wanna guess the world record for the most people crammed inside one? I'll tell you, it's 27. Gymnasts. No idea if they all came out in one piece.
Damn it. We try. Yeah, Phantoms have lost a few of those skill chains early on.
Look at that, laying down some rubber there. Not that it has much to lay. After all, tiny wheels mean tiny tyres. Good work. It might be Mini on the outside, but it's Maxi on the inside. Wanna guess the world record for the most people crammed inside one? I'll tell you, it's 27. Gymnasts. No idea if they all came out in one piece. See, the Mini wasn't just designed for nipping around town. It was also a proper racer and won the British Saloon Car Championship a whopping 5 times.
Better this time round. All it takes is a little bit of practice and yeah, eventually get the hang of it. A little bit tricky to drive though, this thing. Just play its role. Dead on. What's the likelihood of that? Yeah, we don't need to get any more now. How the hell did... Well, that's
right.
Weird.
We're done now. It's time for a spot of sightseeing.
In fact, I built up a skill chain that came to exactly 220,000 points, and that's the exact amount that you need for 3 stars is spooky, to be honest. But at least it only took us a second go to get the full 3 stars. Don't have to come back to it in my own time for sure, and it should mean that we unlock the trapdoor. So, yeah, and it will also mean that we get to see what's for our next level up. What is it? Oh, it's a Stig himself. Even that's all right. So I don't think I actually have his costume. Not that I really chained them. It's more of a bonus kind of thing, but more often than not I do get clothes that I just don't care for whatsoever, and I wish you could change them in for money if you wanted to. Right, nonetheless, I think we've only got 2 more to do. Either way, really enjoying these. Easily one of my favourite Horizon stories. if not my actual favourite. Come on, the fact that we're unlocking new vehicles is a big bonus though.
Here we are then, Edinburgh, where it's time for a spot of turbocharged tourism with this, the mighty Porsche GT2 RS. All we need now is our tour guide, McStig, the world's worst Scotsman, allergic to tartan, absolutely petrified of bagpipes, or so I've heard. Right, let's see if we can visit every bell tower in Edinburgh and get back here before they all stop ringing.
Fair, I'm no fan of bagpipes either. Makes my ears bleed.
Turn left.
What a car this is. 3.8 litre flat 6, 2 turbos, 700 horsepower, all wrapped up in carbon fibre with wings, stripes, holes and vents for snorting in the air.
At the roundabout, take the first exit.
Nippy little thing, isn't it? 0 to 60 takes 2.7 seconds. Just the job for a bit of speedy sightseeing.
Yeah, we don't need binoculars while driving around with this.
Ooh, inch perfect there. It's wider than a regular 911, this GT2, and about 20 times more terrifying. Basically, the perfect device for nipping in and out of city traffic. It might be street legal, but it's only a pair of fireproof underpants away from being a full-blown racing car.
In 200 yards, turn right.
Excellent hooliganry. That's what 700 horsepower and rear-wheel drive will do for you, if you have the guts for it, and an effective laundry detergent.
Yeah, this is a mad car. I've always thought it's probably one of the more insane cars Porsche's ever made. Especially in terms of modern cars.
It's a real masterpiece of engineering, this GT2 RS. The wheels are made from magnesium, the exhaust is titanium. It's exotic, savage and utterly bonkers. I love it!
200 yards, turn sharp right.
Certainly shows that Porsche turn can do something that's equal parts good engineering and generally just insane.
Limited to 211 miles an hour, any faster and it would need special tyres, but with the stick behind the wheel, who knows?
Drifto!
Yards, turn right.
It's the last destination, I imagine.
At the roundabout, take the first
I like this kind of racing though, where we don't know where we're going to be going next.
Into the final stretch now. Note to stick, remember to park properly at the end. And watch out for traffic wardens.
I like this as its actual like own racing mode or something, because this would be fun. Random races that you don't know where you're going to be going next.
Good work! Hard on those carbon ceramic brakes now. They can stop a locomotive dead in its tracks.
Done. Hesitated a little bit there to floor it or slow down. Last minute, but we have got in within the 3 stars. Which means we can now dress up as a Stig if we wanted to. What's our next lock? Ooh, look at that thing. I already know what that it is because I've seen the live stream that they showed it off on, but if you don't, then you're in for a treat. Because it's a car that I think has been requested ever since it was first seen. Well, I first knew of it in when it was shown in a Top Gear episode way back when the original trio were messing about on the program. So yeah, I am really pleased that they put it in, and we're about to unlock it if we get a good rating on this.
I told you we'd finish with a fan's favourite, and here it is. No, not the lorry. The thing in the back, under the tarp. You'll love it. But first, we need to move it into position. Thankfully, we have our very own haulage expert, a trucker's trucker. No load too large. Yes, it's Big Rig Stig.
If we can drive this in the game, then why can't we have it for real?
Right, now take it easy, Stig. That's some expensive cargo you have back there. Costs as much as a house. And weighs about the same, too.
What is it? Yeah, can't we not have this in the real game? I suppose not, because I can't go interior, so I'm guessing it's only something they have the exterior model for. Yeah, you can't even see the Stig inside it. Well, at least we get to drive something that's more known for being just getting in the way.
Worked out what it is yet? Okay, here are some cryptic clues. It's all-wheel drive, but not four-wheel drive. It's a wagon, but you definitely don't need a horse to pull it.
In 200 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Is it the car that I was talking about that we're going to be unlocking? Because if it is, then that first part will make sense. Still pretty cool that we get to drive this thing, especially if you're into your lorries. I'm not particularly into my lorries, but I kind of appreciate kind of engineering that goes into it, and I certainly can appreciate the people that have to drive them
nice
for a living.
Judged. What a machine. Rear-wheel drive too, you know. Not that I'd encourage any sort of sideways behaviour before delivering that cargo. That's 5 tons of flatbed carrying 4 tons on its back. Don't you just hate getting stuck behind a slow, lumbering old... Wait a minute. It's actually accelerating. Up a hill. I guess that's what 900 foot-pounds of torque does for you. That plus trucker Stig.
Come on, nearly there. Not turn all of the understeer.
Whip those covers off.
It's got the same kind of shape of a car that I was thinking.
Suits you, you know. Although, come to think of it, maybe pickups are more your style, especially the one we have in store.
Is it what I think it is? A Mercedes-Benz 6x6. Yes, it is. Yes.
The Mercedes G63 AMG 6x6. It's the ultimate off-roader, a 4-ton, 6-wheel sports utility truck. Basically, a G-Wagon with the back half of a pickup thrown in for free.
Always wanted this on Forza game.
Up front is a 5.3.
I can't remember if we have had it on before.
V8. Usually it's limited to 100
miles an
hour.
Not bothered.
But not this one.
In 100 yards,
I
turn right.
Always wanted to drive one of these on again. It's an ultimate off-roader, like he says, because, yeah. Six-wheel drive means that pretty much nothing is going to stop this. Especially with all the power that it's got going under the hood as well.
With all of the wheels comes all of the grip. The 6x6 turns mountains into motorways. Is there anything it can't conquer? Oh, someone call air traffic control. I'm pretty sure you need a special license to fly one of these.
Like the saying of the old song, ain't no mountain high enough for this thing.
In 400 yards, turn left.
It makes 536 horsepower and more than 760 newton meters of torque. With that speed limiter removed and with the Stig behind the wheel, it'll do 125 miles an hour with a bit of a run up.
I can understand why the car is limited to that kind of speed, though.
It's tough, the 6x6. After all, it was originally made for the Australian Army. It's basically a tank with heated seats.
In 200 yards.
Because, yeah, you would not want to get crushed by this. Even 100 mile an hour, so. Yeah.
It can wade through a meter of water, this thing. Most cars need full scuba kit at that depth. Ridiculous.
In 200 yards, turn left.
Glad they've detailed the suspension there.
Top job there, Stig. Take tomorrow off. No idea what Stig does with Dale. Experimental dance, gait yoga, bog snorting. Anyway, I've been Chris Harris, still am, and this has been the Top Gear Horizon special. Thanks for coming. Now, let's go see what this Forzathon live thing's all about.
No, I'm good. So yeah, there we go. We've got a few new vehicles there. The Traktor, this insane 6x6, and the Mercedes wagon as well, though we will eventually get it in a video. Just haven't got 3 stars and everything, obviously, to get it. But nonetheless, it is a pretty formidable vehicle. And yeah, like I said, we have unlocked the Traktor and the E-Class wagon. We'll quickly show you them, just so you can see. Yeah, there we go. My cars. Mercedes. So yeah, if I deem them usable enough for a video, not sure which, then yeah, they'll definitely get a video of their own at some point. So yeah, there we go. Decent amount of horsepower, torque. Does weigh a fair bit, which is to be expected, but yeah. Far worse diesel engine cars out there on this game, that's for sure. And the Top Gear ones are all going to be all the way over in T. And there we go, that's a Traktor. So yeah, not going to be something that's going to handle all that great with those tiny, skinny wheels at the front, but yeah, whole lot of power and torque. And yeah, going to certainly be interesting to see what we can do with that vehicle at some point. So yeah, let's just get in it, just for a laugh, and then we'll end it there. So yeah, pretty fun Horizon story that is. Like I said, you can unlock 3 vehicles, which, for free, so you don't have to spend money on a car pack or a expansion or anything like that, which is always nice. And yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing what else we can do with them for future videos. But nonetheless, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.